Hey guys, it's A. Lee. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you have not already done so, please subscribe and stay tuned. I'm gonna give you some tips about surviving the little blah. Gosh, if I say that one more time. So yeah, today I'm gonna talk to you guys about tips on how to survive the ICU as a new grad. For those of you who don't know me, I'm a critical care nurse, 3 years in the game, just about, and I'm currently in California on a travel nursing assignment. Primarily, I work the surgical transplant ICU. As y'all know, once you graduate nursing school, you take your NCLEX, the real work begins, especially if you're a new grad. Oh, I'm so excited to start. I'm through at nursing school, I graduated, I took my NCLEX, I passed the NCLEX, bring it on, I'm ready for whatever. Yeah, you better be ready for this because it's a whole new playing field. A lot of you have been asking me tips on how to survive the ICU. How did you get through it? Guys, I know, trust me. Been there, done that. So really today, I really want you guys just take 3 easy tips that really, really helped me survive the ICU as a new grad. Tip number 1. Ask questions. May not come as a surprise, as you all know, there's no dumb questions, especially when you're a new nurse. Please, please, please ask questions. You're new. You don't know anything about the ICU. So rule number 1, always ask questions. Some stuff you can look up. I always Googled, like if I didn't know something, I would like get my phone on Google, but if Google wasn't like thorough enough for me to like really grasp, I'd ask the question. That's tip number 1. Tip number 2. Take notes, okay? I don't care if you have a little paper flip packet in your pocket, use your phone. Shoot, really, that's what I did. I just used my phone. I literally would write down at least 5 new things that I learned from the day on my phone. Whether it's a medication, a procedure, a drip, a teaching point from your preceptor or the doctor, MD, anything you learn, write it down. You are brand spanking new, okay? Most of the things that you hear is gonna go in one ear and out the other without you even trying to do that, okay? Everything is just so new. It's easy for things to kind of like roll off. So if you write it down, it allows you more time to digest it. When you get home, you can actually look it up or just review it so it sticks. Reinforcement is key because you're most likely gonna see it over and over again throughout your course in the ICU. So why not get it now, know it, study it, at least one thing you didn't know about it. That's my tip number 2. So take notes. Tip number 3, guys, this kind of goes with tip number 2. Self-study. This kind of, yeah, it goes with number 2. Because when you get home, I know you're like, oh, I survived, I'm glad that's over, and you don't want to look at anything. Nope. As a new grad, you have to do this step. So self-study is key, because while you're at work, you're pretty much trying to get your tasks done, pass meds, and not kill the patient. So when you get home, you kind of get to reinforce everything you learned. The notes you wrote down from step 2, you get to kind of read and digest it fully. Because let me tell you, when I was a new grad, guys, it was, the learning curve was so steep. Like, nursing school what? NCLEX who? Breeze. Starting fresh in ICU for me was a bit of a challenge. Not to mention that my preceptor wasn't the greatest, but we won't go there. Most importantly, guys, don't get discouraged. Easier said than done, I know. But literally, you're new. Everything is new. The lines, the tubing in the pump is probably new, because as nursing students, come on, what nurse lets you, you know, titrate drugs or give injections, push me, not many. And I mean, that's fine because you're a nursing student, you're really just there to kind of get an idea of what life will be after nursing school, because that's a whole nother story once you graduate. But yes, guys, don't get discouraged. There is a learning curve. You're new, accept it, work through it, stay motivated, and keep learning. The learning doesn't stop. I'm 3 years in it today and I'm learning something new still. There are nurses that are 20 years older than me that ask me questions. If you are asking questions, guys, you're not really learning. There's always something that you can learn from anyone at any point in your nursing career. So share below some things that you guys struggled with during your new grad program or just being a new nurse in general. Just let me know. Post below. Ailey, out.